sports report.
I'm watching what?
David Graham's sports report.
Okay. What are you guys watching?
Basketball game.
Okay.
Contrary to what you may have heard, the diner is not closing. Let me repeat that again. The diner on Jacksboro Pike is not closing. As a matter of fact, the diner has been serving this area for 7 years and plans on serving you for many more years to come with daily lunch and specials, fresh homemade desserts, and they still take great big food orders. So, let me repeat this one more time. The diner is not closing. So, having said that, we'll see you soon at the diner on Jacksboro Pike, home of great food, great people, and great service.
When you call for just any ambulance service, you never know what you might get. But when you call Vinyl Care at 423-562-9370, you'll get an experienced staff, experienced and professional people who know what the word emergency really means. Don't just trust anyone. You do have a choice when it comes to ambulance service in this area.
562-9370.
Thanks for watching my papa on WLAF.
Our top story today could be a lot of things, but it's the Jacksboro Middle School Eagles boys team who shocked the world in beating Cleveland to advance into the Final Four Friday at 8:15 p.m. against Maryville. Cody Parker was very confident in his young men and talked about how they outplayed the Cleveland team. It was a struggle, though, with the big 6'4" center they had in there, but once he drew his second technical foul, his night was over and the Eagles' night had just begun. Here's Coach Parker with his thoughts on that big win.
And then, you know, he said some things to the officials, both of them, and they both teed him up and threw him out of the game. And, you know, from that point forward, I never felt like we lost control of the basketball game. I mean, they would cut the lead down and cut it down, but I never felt like we were going to lose the game. We know a little bit about Maryville, and, you know, those guys, I mean, they're always good no matter what they do. And, you know, we're happy to be there and we're excited about it. But I also believe that our kids are ready to continue on.
We're sad to report, though, that the Blue Devils lost to Oakdale in the 1A tourney at Catlettsburg Elementary School 41-21. Wow. That doesn't sound like the Blue Devil team we covered in the Area 2 tourney when they ran roughshod through everyone. Tony Smith broke his foot the day before the game, and the team was a little bit thrown off. They missed, according to Coach Darrell Burge, about 25 layups, and that too doesn't sound like the team we saw. But they'll be back next year, but we'll start with some new faces, as a lot of these guys will help Mike Reynolds build another dynasty at the next level. Speaking of Jellicoe High School, the Blue Devils were at Sunbright Thursday night, coming off their two wins, the first one over Oakdale and the next one over a good Lynn Camp team, winning the Sunbright, needing a big district win. Everyone was in foul trouble except Danny Dino Oaks, who was on the call for 1450WLF.com. Even Coach Mike Reynolds got teed up. The Devils, who went into enemy territory, desperately needing to keep on trucking in the win column as the Blue Devils want to improve their standing in the district. But the Tigers of Sunbright weren't going to cooperate as they sit in second place in the district. They started out with four straight turnovers on their first four possessions. The refs were calling fouls like they were giving out candy, and the Devils still lost 54-48. If it weren't for all-district selection Kyle Gunner and his 32 points, we would have won 48-22. But it wasn't to be. Now we fall to 8-17, and more importantly, 5-7 in the district. No one really stepped up for our boys in black, white, and blue tonight. But then again, everyone was in foul trouble. Friday night, Campbell County High School is at home to face the Mavericks of Anderson County High School. And I will finally get back up to John R.W. Brown Gymnasium with my friend Jim Freeman on the call on the WLAF Pilot Sports Network at 1450WLF.com. Now, the girls' game will tip off at 5 p.m., so get up there early to get a good seat. Saturday, Cosby comes to play the Blue Devils in another district game that the Blue Devils absolutely, positively have to move up in district. Then on Monday, Jellicoe will turn right around and play at Cosby. So, Big Blue, let's just win them both and get it over with. Now, join our very own Vic King on the call at 1450WLF.com. I've been doing the games, the past couple of games, and I really enjoyed it. And we came out of there with two wins. So, Vic, you got to keep the streak going, buddy. Congratulations to Justin Bowen, who was selected All-District from Jellicoe High School. Honorable mentions went out to Matt Bolton, Austin Hundley, and Brian Hicks. See, they fear their beard, too. It was a Cougar signing day at our middle schools Thursday as Justin Price was at Jacksboro Middle School early that morning and later on he was at La Follette Middle School. 26 young men signed up at Jacksboro Middle School. Coach talked about what the Cougars and their program and people are all about. He showed them a video of last year's achievements, but he took time to talk to us here at WLAF. And here's what he had to say.
Well, it's just about us coming to our middle schools and kind of promoting our program. You know, and tell them all the good things that are going on at Campbell County, not just football, but, you know, in a lot of different areas. And I think the more they feel they know what's going on, that it helped ease the transition, which I know the kids enjoy, but I think the parents are more comforting than they are.
Later on, he was at La Follette Middle School, and they had 38 young men signed up, so that's a good-sized freshman team, I'd say. But they're all in, and we'll let you know more about the football program as they let us know. We do know this. Their first scrimmage is at South Doyle on May the 17th. Hey, don't forget, Slayton Allen will sign with the University of the Cumberlands Monday in the library at 9 a.m., and we'll get up there and bring you back a full report. Hey, you guys know me. I'm Shifty. I'll cover stuff. Okay, that's a real quick look at today's sports. We'll remind you to follow the Cougars and the Blue Devils right here on the WLAF Pilot Sports Network at 1450WLAF.com. Hey, stay tuned. There's a lot more to come right here on WLAF.